पॉवर्टी एज अ चैलेंज। So poverty, poverty, it is a situation in which a person unable to complete their basic needs. Basic needs, what are the basic needs of every person as a food, shelter, clothing? Food, shelter, clothing. So the which can't complete, the person which can't complete their basic needs, food, shelter, and clothing, is considered as the under poverty. That person consider as under poverty. Under poverty. A person which can't complete their basic necessities, basic needs, is known as the poverty. Poverty has varied from a country to country. All over the world, there is not as an equal status of a poverty. It's due to the per capita income. Unequal distribution of a per capita income in economies responsible for the expansion of poverty. The trends of poverty. Trends of poverty are influenced by the per capita income. This is the average income. Average income or per capita income. Presently in our country, 29% of a total population living the under poverty. 29% living under poverty. 29% of a total number of a people in our country. Our country's population is near about 130 crores. So 29% of 130 crores, it will be as a near about the 40, near about the 40 crores of the population. It's such kind of a population which can't complete their basic necessities of food, shelter, and clothing. Which can't complete their basic necessities of food, shelter, and clothing. When a larger section of the people in an economy, larger section of people in an economy, when a larger section, not only as a limited number of a people, a large section of a population in an economy are deprived of these basic necessities, that economy is said to be the mass poverty. When a large section of a population unable to complete their basic necessities is known as the mass poverty. It is known as the mass poverty. It is known as the mass poverty. There are two kinds of the poverty existing in our country. Two kinds of poverty existing in our country. One as the relative poverty. Second is as the absolute poverty. Let's start from the first, relative poverty. Relative poverty. Under relative poverty, under relative poverty, the economic conditions of different regions, or countries of world is compared. When we compare the different countries or regions of world are compared on the basis of the poverty is known as the relative poverty. It is known as the relative poverty. For relative poverty, we use two indicators, per capita income and national income. These two indicators are used to compare the different economies of the world. For example, India with Pakistan, India with the US, India with China, India with the Japan. What kind of the income differences are there? National income, per capita income and national income. Per capita income, how can we calculate a per capita income? Rule number 23. If 23 is there, raise your hand. 23. Raise your hand. Rule number eight, Priyanshka given correct answer. Very good girl. Yes. What about others? Eight rule number. I think it's a Charvi. Charvi, are you there? Charvi.
Sir, may I answer?
Yes, answer. Tidiksha.
Sir, per capita income is calculated by total income of area upon total population.
Very good. One thing, area, not the area as a country. Here we are calculating the income of a country. So very good.
Okay,
Tisha, Jia, Mago, both are given as the same correct answer. Riyanshika also. Total income earned from a three sectors. Primary sector, secondary sector, tertiary sector. Income earned from those professions of a primary, secondary and tertiary divided by the total population of a country. Total population of a country through which we can calculate as a per capita income. Per capita income is calculated on the basis of a country, India level, neither as a state level. It's on a country level. Per capita income and a national income. Girls contributed in a today's class. What about the boys? Boys, how can we calculate as a national income? 9th D boys. Dhairi, how can we calculate a national income? I think we discussed regarding it in a second chapter of economics, GNP, gross national product. GDP is a sum value of a income earned from a three sectors, primary, secondary, tertiary. Yes, Brijesh Chitkara. Brijesh, Aryan, Arush, Dhairi. National income is the total income of nation. Total income means as a primary, secondary, tertiary. That's it. Primary, secondary and tertiary. Yes, Aryan. Okay, Arush, ready to answer. Yes, Arush.
No, sir, your voice started cracking all of a sudden.
It's due to a technical problem. We can't do this. Arush. Okay. Yes. Now, Karanvi, your turn. Karanvi Singh.
Sir, it is a sum of wages, interest, and rent.
Wages, interest, and?
Rent.
Rent. Okay. Income earned, these individuals which are moving towards as America, Canada, in Dubai, UAE, anywhere, they are earning in a such countries, but afterwards as a spending in our country. They are spending such money, such income to their families, and ultimately as a such income as a circulating within our economy, So total income earned from the abroad plus income earned within a country. Income earned within a country is to which as we can calculate as a national income. These two indicators are used to estimate the relative poverty. Those countries where the per capita income is a higher, national income is a higher, in such countries as a poverty not exist. Poverty, it has not exist in a such economies where per capita income is a higher. For which as a World Bank use a criteria, per capita income. Per capita income for categorization of a world economies. Like as a developed nations. We are using as a word developed. Developed countries. Developed are those countries of a world which are possessing, which are having as a per capita income. Per capita income 4,35,500. 4,35,500. Those countries where the per capita income is a more than the 4,35,500 annual basis. These are the developed countries like Japan, US, England. These are the developed countries of the world. Developed countries. Second category as a developing countries, which are now as improving. Such economies are improving at present. These are developing countries, developing nations. Developing nations. In these countries, the per capita income has lies in between of 35,500 to 35,500 to 4,35,500. 4,35,500. These are the developing, which are now as improving. In near in future, after 10, 20, 30, 50, 100 years, they may declare as a developed nations. Such economies, such countries, they may declare as the developed countries in near in future, not in the present, not possible in the present, but after the some span of time, to the completion of their needs, to the eradication of a poverty, to the generation of employment opportunities, they can reach at the level of a development. But the third countries are there, underdeveloped countries, which are lagging behind. Underdeveloped, which are not now as the good in status. It's due to their growing population, the growth of population, under which India has lies under the underdeveloped countries. No doubt, India is also the improving their economic standards, but side by side, the population also increasing at an alarming rate. Population of our country also increases as per the alarming rate. That's why as a poverty still existed in our country. Pakistan is also the underdeveloped nation. Underdeveloped. If we use the criteria of a per capita income, then the India has rights under the underdeveloped. But if we use the other indicators, like as a national income earned from the abroad also, from the foreign also, then India lies under developing nations. Developing nations. We are improving. When we compare as a status of a poverty in India, at the time of independence, 63% people were under poverty. In a time of 1947, 63% of people were under poverty. But now as of presently, as according to a 2021, the 29% of people are still under poverty. So the ratio is decreasing day by day. It's due to as the improving structure, due to as a planning commission. Due to the planning commission, such standards are improving. Now at poverty are reducing. It indicates as India as a developing nation. If we use the other criteria, neither only as a per capita, other indicators. Clear? Is that clear? Relative poverty is a that state of a poverty in which we compare the economies based upon a per capita income and national income. Clear? Any doubts still there? Yes? anybody having any doubts? When we compare the different economies of a world in relation to the per capita income and national income, it's known as a relative poverty. It is known as the relative poverty. Till there any doubts? Till there any doubts? Yes, Divya.
Sir, what is the example of developing countries?
Developing countries, if we use only as a criteria of a per capita income. Per capita income, under which the Nepal is a developing nation. Sri Lanka is a developing nation. Bangladesh, India, Pakistan, these are the underdeveloped nations. But why? Because in such countries, as a number of natural resources are a lesser comparatively the population resource. As compared to the human resource, availability of a human resource is a more comparatively the natural resources. That's why these economies are underdeveloped. In Nepal, they are controlling as on their population. China is a developed nation. No doubt, their population is also the high as more comparatively to India, but they are possessing the more surface area also. The surface area of China is more as compared to the India. This is as the fourth largest country of the world in area wise. Due to as their surface area, the population resource is also the higher. That's why they handle that still as a China is developed nation. Clear? This is as a relative poverty. Now the next part is absolute poverty. Divya, clear? Absolute poverty. Next as the absolute poverty. Absolute poverty refers to the measure of poverty, measuring of poverty, keeping in view the per capita intake of calories. Per capita intake of calories. Calories consumption. It means every person in rural and urban areas requires a certain number of calories in a day. If a person living in a rural areas, it requires as a 2400 calories in a day. An adult in a rural areas required 2400 calories in a day. In a urban areas, a person require, Brijesh require as a 2100 calories in a day. 2100 calories in a day. A person living in a urban areas require 2100 calories in a day. So that person which can't complete their, that person which can't complete their such calorie consumption, this is as a minimum ratio, such calorie consumption, that person can consider as a under poverty. The person can consider as the under poverty. For which as an estimation of a poverty, we are using as a two criteria. Two methods are there. One is the expenditure method. Second is the income method. For the estimation of a poverty, we use the two criteria, two methods. Estimation of a poverty, two methods are there. Expenditure method and income method. Expenditure method and income method. Income method. Idea is used to check data whether a person is a healthy, overweight or undernourished, for which as we use a criteria as BMI, body mass index. Body mass index. It has calculated to as the, first of all, we have to measure the height of an individual in a meters. Height of individual in meters. For example, if we take as a example of mine, my height is a 5 feet 10 inches, 10.5 inches, near about a 180 centimeters. You have to calculate the height of the individual, height of individual in meters divided by the total weight of a that individual, which should be in a kilograms. Weight, it should be in kilograms. So you have to divide the height of an individual in meters, divide by the square of a weight. Mind weight is as the 76, square of 76. If your that particular, if your data, that particular information, that particular, answer, it is as the less than the 15, less, it is the less than the 25, sorry, it is a less than the 25, the person is a less than the 25, 15 to 25 is the person is a healthy. If the less than the 15 is there, then the person is a undernourished. It has not taking as an adequate diet. Proper caloric consumption has not, calories are not given to the, that particular individual. That's why the person is undernourished. But if the answer, your answer is more than the 26, then the, that particular 25, sorry, more than the 25, the person is overweight. Clear there? That person, it will be become as the overweight. So BMI, through which we can calculate that the health status of any of an individual as personally. Caloric consumption, which is required by the every person, 2400 calories in a rural areas, 2100 calories in a urban areas. 2400, why? Because in rural areas, as a people engaged in a manual activities, at the labor work, manual activities, that's why they require as a 2400 calories, and a 2100 calories are desired. 2100 calories required for a person which is living in a urban areas. 2100 calories required by a person in urban areas for a healthy life. So those person, those people which can't complete such basic requirement of a calories, they are considered under the poverty. Clear? Types of a poverty, clear? Till there any questions? Types of poverty. Any questions? Types of poverty. If the per capita income is a lower, it indicates as a relative poverty. In between our two countries, it will be known as a relative poverty. Absolute poverty as that when we check that the proper nutritious and calorie consumption intake took by the individual. These approaches, expenditure method and income method, are used for the calculation of poverty in our country. Calculation of poverty in our country. So expenditure method means as a how much money you are spending for a completion of your basic caloric consumption. Basic caloric consumption for which as a total money which is spent by the individual, to which this is known as an expenditure method. For example, and list the number of a material which has used by the Rishikesh their day-to-day life. Means all those eatables, all those materials which are daily used by the Rishikesh in their diet. For example, as a 15 chapatis, 3 glasses of milk, pulses, cereals, whatever the materials which are used in a daily life. Neither as a pizza or a burger which are used in a really once or twice in a week. No, not as such products. Only as those goods which are used in a daily life. Clear? For example, if we estimate that the one chapati, which has constitutes as the 80 calories, 15 chapatis means 1200 calories. Rishikesh taking as the 1200 calories through the chapatis. 3 milk glasses, average each glass consisting of the 120 calories. 120 calories means as a 360, 1200 chapatis, then the 360 from the milk. 1560, and the remaining calorie consumption required for the Rishikesh as the near about 540 as a desired, which are completing through as the vegetables, through the fruits or the pulses. If the Rishikesh completed their 2100 calories in a day, then it can live as a healthy life. It will consider as above poverty. It will consider as above poverty. We will continue this on a next period. Any questions?